and you're gonna really come with this nonsense. You know this is prejudice. They go, no, we talked to our neighbors and they said they weren't racist, so that's not the issue. I was like, are you kidding me? I was like, do they need to come in the damn Klan outfit to show you that they're racist? I was like, they're racist. I was like, what though, did they motorcyclist? I was like, really? Cause I was trying to be smart. Like, I don't look at people as color. I look at people as human beings. And the fact that they want to kick my daughter out of her place of residence, they want to lock my garage doors because nothing else worked. I was like, you got to see past it. They said, no, sir, you're violating your ordinance. And to change the ordinance, the variance, you have to go back in front of the zoning board. The zoning board's the only people that can amend that. And I was like, great, well, have them change it. You see, this is racist. They're like, no, you're going to have to go back there because it's not racist because they said they're not racist. And you're going to go back there. You got to pay for a zoning hearing and have them be relieve you of the restrictions against you. I'm like, okay, then that's what we'll do. This is obvious prejudice. I'm going to go in front of a board. They're obviously going to see all the complaints and all the invalid complaints. They're going to see right through this charade. So I pay my couple thousand dollar fees, got an expensive lawyer, you know what I mean? And we go back to the township meeting. Find out I got one neighbor. One neighbor and her neighbor. So there's two people that are complaining against me. So I have the courtroom filled of all my customers. Half of the customers are police officers and military of my customers and local residents who are my customers, because you cannot go to the township meeting unless you're a resident of the township. So I've packed the courtroom, standing room only. And you got these two people in the front. I state my case. I was told I was allowed to use the apartment for personal use, and the zoning board denied it. They said, absolutely not. You were never allowed to use that board. That was never said. The stenographer notes were gone. The company was out of business, and you couldn't get copies of any of the official statements. So it was whatever they said goes. So we're in there. I had a petition signed by over 500 people. They disregarded. They didn't care about what any of us had to say. So we plead our case, we tell them, like, listen, the amendment that was made after the fact is null and void, but regardless, we're here to be relieved of these restrictions. How can you operate a business? The floor plan was approved. How do you expect this shop to operate when you can come out of one bay? One bay you could bring vehicles in and out and to work out, to fill your showroom, to do anything. One bay, when the place was originally six garage bays, door closed, two down for the showroom. And they wanted me to lock the other three. So I plead my case, standing room only. Who's in favor of tricked out cycles? The whole place is hands in the air. Who's not? The two people in the front row. And they said they don't care what we need to do. They said the paint fumes were killing them. They're like, whoa, whoa, whoa. We're not here to discuss paint. Oh, we are. They're killing us. You know, he's polluting the air. He's using cheap paint from China. They used every story under the book to try to paint a picture that I'm doing things illegal. But nothing was valid. It was almost comical. We sat in that courtroom like, yo, there's no way they're going to go against me. And lo and behold, they did. You know, they don't give you the ruling that day after the court's over. They do it in writing because they didn't want to make a stink because it was so obviously wrong. So get a writing. Lo and behold, they came and padlocked the three garage doors. And I had to evict my daughter out of the apartment and leave it empty. Have to use it for in office space. I have to use it if it's part of the business. When it was rented before, occupied before. And then they tried to hit me with, it's illegal to have a living residence above a place of business. When I can count on the corridor right down the street from me, over 17 places that people are doing the exact thing. Right next door. They live above that. So a lot of people are doing what they say can't be done. But they said it only applies to me because I'm restricted. So I lost. We appealed. We went to the higher level of Doylestown Court. They kicked it back and said, this is a local problem. And they denied any of my requests. So imagine you have a business, thriving business, well-known, you're on TV shows, you're on magazines, and the neighbors don't want you here, two neighbors, and the police go ahead with that prejudice and enforce that rule and try to shut me down.